Everyone, now we are going to discuss about erosion and problems of deposition in irrigation system. Unit 2, environmental impacts. The subject name is environmental and engineering. Surface irrigation and rainfall in agriculture, land erosion. The most obvious difference between soil erosion from rain or sprinkler irrigation and from surface irrigation is the lack of water droplet impacting the soil during surface irrigation. This fundamental difference is important because droplet kinetic energy affect both erosion and infiltration. When rain begins, droplet wet the soil surface and detach soil particles. As runoff begins, rills form in wet soil. Water flowing in rills, it also exposed to falling raindrops, which affect detachment, transport, and deposition in the rills. So, problem caused by erosion, damage to sea coast and formation of sand dunes, disease and public health hazards, spent of money on water purification works, siltation of irrigation canals, rivers and reservoir, problem in crop irrigation and consequent need of conserving the water. Soil erosion mechanics, the basic thing is, soil erosion mechanic can be divided into three components: detachment, transport, and deposition. Water droplet and flowing water detach soil particles. Flowing water then transport these detached particles downstream. Deposition occurs when flowing water can no longer transport the soil particles because flow rate decreases as water infiltration or as rill slope or roughness changes. Some particles are deposited within a few meters, although others are transported off the field with runoff water. These mechanisms are the same for surface irrigation, sprinkler irrigation, and rainfall. However, these are some systematic differences between irrigation and rainfall erosion, and especially between surface irrigation and rainfall. So here, soil erosion agents. So basic sediment cannot be transported without runoff. Runoff is planned with many surface irrigation scheme in order to irrigate all areas of the field adequately. Under ideal condition, properly designed and managed sprinkler irrigation system will not have any runoff from the irrigated area. However, economic and water supply constraints along with variable slope and soil condition often force compromises in sprinkler irrigation design. So here the main characteristic for erosion is wind, water, and gravity. So wind caused by wind velocity, water forms and glaciers, gravity, mass soil movement in form of landslide, landfall, debris and creep. So here water forms rainfall or runoff. Rainfall causes splash erosion like surface runoff and subsurface runoff. So classification of erosion. The hydraulic of rill flow from rain differ from furrow irrigation. Rill flow rate tends to increase downstream as additional rainwater plus sheet. Then rill flow combined. During furrow irrigation, flow rate decreases with distance down the furrow as water infiltrate and increases with time as infiltration rate decreases, which changes sediment detachment and transport capacities with distance and time. Basically, erosion may be broadly classified into two groups. One is geological erosion, second one is accelerated erosion. The geological erosion contains natural or normal erosion, it without infiltration of human. The agents of natural erosion is water, wind, gravity and glaciers. Losses of soil equaled formation of new soil. Accelerated erosion is influence of human activities like equilibrium between soil building and soil removal is disturbed. So, removal of surface soil takes much faster than soil formation process. The agents are water and wind. These are all the primary agent. It classified into two, water erosion and wind erosion. In our India, total geographical area 326 million hectare of land. Eroded area is 81 million hectare. So here some factors responsible for soil erosion: excessive deforestation and overgrazing, faulty agrarian practices. So what is excess deforestation is? Deforestation is ongoing and is shaping climate and geography. And also deforestation is a contributor to global warming and is often cited as one of the major causes of the enhanced greenhouse effect. So tropical deforestation is responsible for approximately 20% of world greenhouse gas emission. So overgrazing is, overgrazing occur when plant are exposed to intensive grazing for extended period of time or without sufficient recovery periods. It can be caused by either livestock in poorly managed agriculture application and natural reservoirs. Faulty agrarian practices are, much of the soil erosion in India is caused by faulty method of agriculture. The most outstanding are wrong plugging, lack of crop rotation and practice of shifting cultivation. So next is effect of erosion. Soil erosion reduces cropland productivity and contribution to the population of adjacent watercourses, wetland and lakes. Soil erosion can be a slow process that continues relatively unnoticed or can occur at an alarming rate, causing serious loss of topsoil. Number one effect is loss of productivity or fertile soil. Next is deposition of sand on productive land, silting of lake and reservoir, water scarcity, fragmentation of land. Thank you. Hope we understood.